Hi everyone, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I'll be making mozzarella cheese at home with just two ingredients. This recipe is super easy as we are not using rennet in this recipe, so the recipe become more simpler and easier. So let me show you how to make this mozzarella cheese. So here I have 1 liter milk that I placed for warming up. You can take either pasteurized or non-pasteurized milk, doesn't matter. Just make sure the milk is not ultra pasteurized. We are going to boil the milk on high flame for just 4 minutes. Not more than that, not less than that. In 4 minutes, the milk will get the right temperature to make the cheese. So that's why just for 4 minutes. Now the milk has warmed up for 4 minutes. Switch off the heat now. Now we need to curdle the milk. So add 1 tablespoon vinegar at a time and keep mixing. Depending on the quality of milk, the vinegar can be taken more or less. Here I'll be using 7 tablespoon of vinegar to curdle the milk. Make sure the milk is not boiling. If the milk is boiling, it won't be mozzarella cheese. It will be something else like cottage cheese or chena. And see the cheese, it looks like stretchy, like mozzarella cheese. So as you can see how easily you can make mozzarella cheese at home. Now we will collect the cheese. So take a strainer. On the strainer I put a cotton cloth to collect the cheese. Now the cheese is collected. Now press the cheese with your hands. Drain off the excess water as much as possible. So now I am removing the cloth and now press it tightly using your palms and remove all the excess water. Make sure you remove all the excess water from the cheese. Even 1 drop of water can spoil our mozzarella cheese. Once it is done, we'll go to second step. So take a bowl of lukewarm water. In this water, we are going to dip the cheese for a few seconds and then take out. Now we have to stretch the cheese. In this way the cheese will be stretchy. It will bring elasticity in the cheese. So see, we're dipping the cheese again and again and stretching like this. And also make sure after stretching no water remains in the cheese. After completing this, we'll go to third step. Now take normal room temperature water and put the cheese in this. We will repeat the same process, dipping and stretching out, but now we will do it for 2 times. So see, dip in the water and take out, then start stretching. After stretching, press out the cheese to make sure there is no water in the cheese. Now take a small bowl. Now we will wrap the cheese and keep in the refrigerator for 2 hours. So in a bowl, I am covering the cheese with a cling film. Make sure you cover it up very well. Otherwise, the air will go inside and it will get hard layer on the top. So now keep in the refrigerator for 2 hours. After that, your cheese is ready. Now let me show you the cheese is perfectly done or not. So now the mozzarella cheese is ready. You can slice it like this and use, or you can also grate it. Now let me show you whether the cheese is done or not. So in one bread I have added slices of cheese. In another bread I am adding grated cheese. If the cheese is being heated, it will be melted and also create string. So now we are going to toast the bread for 1 minute until the cheese is melted. See, now the cheese is melted. Let me show you if it creates string or not. Using a toothpick, I'm going to pull the cheese and as you can see, the cheese is creating strings. So my mozzarella cheese is done. You can give it different shapes and also it can be used on pizza, burger or even simple bread or roti. So guys, if you like this recipe, please hit the like button, share with your family and friends. And feel free to comment in the comment box. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Sharmila's Kitchen. I'll see you soon. Till then, take care and bye.